but I'm going to say something right off the bat, there's no reason why you should try.
They are.
No, they don't.
I know, that's why I'm so excited that you said that.
But I do recommend this, your room should all be cocktails. If you want to use the bathroom for your raccoons and somewhere else for another species, fantastic. But rats have incredible sense of smell and they're very psychic. So they know there's a great horned owl in the garage. And they absolutely know there's a raccoon in the area of the garage. They know it and then they'll go, oh, check me out, bye. When I was the wildlife manager for Aegis US, the first thing I knew when I got the cave was totally changed around how they did their wildlife. And all of a sudden, everything started to live. Squirrels can go with bunnies, no problem. Everything is a predator to a bunny except for a butterfly. Okay? And you have to be very calm, very zen, very zen. And I'm happy to train. I train all over the world. I've trained in Alaska, Scotland. I've trained in Alaska. And it's amazing with Skype community. Cottontails in the North Texas area are now considered infested species. And the reason why is because our cities, bless their hearts, and we do understand why, tend to euthanize their predators. And so when we lose our bobcats, when we have screwed with our environment so much that we no longer have sufficient habitats for our wildlife, we start having overabundance of certain species, including deer and turkey and cottontails. In the North Texas area, I see over 1,000 cottontails a year in Arizona. You can walk in my house, you can look at my book, and you go, oh my God, look at all the people that have been in your house. And that's why I love this flag. Whatever one this is. Anyhow, they're born precocial, or altricial rather, they're born ice cold, no fur. All they can do is sense vibration of their mom popping through the nest. They can't see, they can smell, they can taste, that's it. It's not until they're 10 days old that their eyes open. It's not until they're 2.5 years old that all of a sudden their instincts kick in and you're not the mom anymore. And that's what you do with things. And I'm happy to be Johnson Puppy Cow and Serena Puppy Cow. And I've been doing this for 30 years. So, we're old, we want to retire. So please, somebody step up. We now have some excellent rehabilitators in the Arlington area. We have some popping up here in Plano, which is awesome. But we need more. So if I see 1,000 cottontails a year, you can only imagine what the fleet is dumping. The more pesticides and herbicides we use on our beautiful Bermuda grass lawns, the worse it is for everything we do to our children. Whoa. So when our cottontails start becoming endangered species, which has happened at the East Coast, the Wayward cottontail is now on the almost endangered species list, and I got to pick up those graduates out there. It is only a matter of time before our prey animals catch up. So what happens if something happens to our cottontails? There go our raptors, there go our bobcats, there go our coyotes. And I'm going to say this real quick, if you're a cottontail rehabilitator, do not for 1 minute hesitate to put that baby in a Ziploc bag and put it in the freezer so that it can go to another rehabilitator and get its natural food.
Only after it dies.
Absolutely. So, what do you want to know about cocktails? Let's do some engaging here. What would you like to know?